Hello Python programmers, this is Aki. In this video, we are going to learn about how to create a software application that checks the internet speed using Python. In this video, we are going to use two Python modules to develop this application. And I made this application within a short span of time by using Tinter and PySpeed test modules. So these are the two modules, okay? So I will show you how to make this application within a few lines of code. Let's create this application. And one more thing is, don't skip the video, otherwise you cannot understand the codes. First, you need to import the Tinter module, and next you need to import the message box library that is present in the Tinter. And then import PySpeed test module. So these are the modules that we use to create this application. Tinker is for graphics and PySpeed test module is used to get the internet speed results. So these are the duties of this module. Okay. And this step is the main step in the entire program. In this step, we are going to write our logics. So declare a function called as logic. Under this function, we need to write the important logic. So follow my instructions carefully. Declare a variable called as st. And inside this variable, we need to write pyspeedtest.speedtest. This is an object. And open the brackets. Inside the brackets, write any website name. Here I inserted google.com. Why we are using this website means we are going to test our internet speed by using this site. This website is act as a source to check the internet speed. And declare another variable called as a. In this variable, we need to call the object download. This library offers three objects. That is, you can check the download speed by calling the download object. And second one is, you can check the upload speed by calling the upload object. And the third one is ping. By calling the ping object, you can get the ping of your network. So this is the logic behind that module. Here I call the object named as download. So I can get my download speed. So this is the simple logic. And you need to display the download speed results in a message box like this. Okay. So create an object called as messagebox.showInfo. Inside this object, you need to write the title of your message and call the variable that holds the download speed data. So here the A variable that holds my download speed data. Here I inserted title as your download speed. And next, I call the variable A. So this is the logic of this program. I hope you understand the logic of this program. Next, we need to concentrate on the graphical parts. So declare an object top equal to tk. This is used to initialize the Tinker object in your program. I think you all know about this. Next, you need to give the title of your application. So write top.title. Here I give title as akspeedtest. And next, you need to assign the geometry of your application. So I gave 100 into 100. So these are the combinations of height and width. And the next one is, you need to insert the image in your application. Why we are inserting the image means, by inserting the image, your application looks more attractive. One. For inserting the photo, you need to declare the variable as file name. Inside this variable, write photo image. This is an object. And inside the object, mention the path of your image file. And next step is, we need to arrange the image in the correct positions. So I created two variables to arrange the positions of the image. And finally, you need to call the last variable as B. This variable is used to create a button. and in the button variable I inserted some basic attributes like text, font style and background colors, height and width. In the final set of attributes, we need to call the logic function in the command parameters. This is the second part of the coding. So this part teaches you how to give the graphical elements into your application and call the main object top.mainloop. Let's check how our output looks like. So click the run button to run the program. So look at the interface of the application that we created. Click the button to see the download speed result on the screen. So look at the screen. It will produce the output as some numbers. These numbers represent your download speed data in byte formation, not megabyte formation, in byte formation. Okay. If you want to change this format of data, like you want to display the upload speed result, then you need to call the upload object in the initial steps that we created in the program. Okay, so that's all about this video. I hope you understand the concepts in the video. If you like this video, give a like and comment down your suggestions about this video and make sure to hit the subscribe button. That's all. Thanks for watching and thank you.